My dear colleague, welcome back to the KA YouTube channel. Today we are going to talk about the patella. Should we resurface the patella or not when performing kinematically aligned total knee replacement? So my name is Charles Rivière. I'm a hip and knee surgeon working between Bordeaux and London, part of the MSK Lab Imperial College London. So first, I would like to remind you the multiple technique to align implants. You've got here patient with a severe constitutional virus. So three systematic techniques for implanting component exist: the AMA technique, anatomical alignment, and the adjusted mechanical alignment. The first technique significantly alters the anatomy of most patients. The second technique try to reproduce or to preserve 2 to 3 degree joint line lubricity for every patient. And the third technique maintain few degree of varus deformity for patient with the constitutional varus. So this technique only apply for varus arthrotic patient. Two personalized techniques appear over the last decade. Functional alignment is a newborn. It's a sophisticated way to implant components, and you use unique technology for this. Today, the topic is on kinematically alignment technique. So this is a physiological implantation of the total knee components. So the simple definition is that it's when you do kinematic implantation, you do a true knee resurfacing. The amount of bone and cartilage removed equal the thickness of the implant. There is no collateral ligament release. The only thing you can release is the posterior capsule if you want to reduce a fixation deformity. If patient have a severe frontal limb deformity and you want to reduce this deformity, you will do a restricted kinematic alignment, and then you may need to do some soft tissue release. So patients that need a restricted kinematic alignment are only a minority. And when you do that, soft tissue release are only minimal. The complex definition is that you align the implant on the knee kinematic axis that dictate the motion of the tibia and the patella around the femur. So let's keep it simple. If you manage to do a pure knee resurfacing, then automatically your implants will end up aligned on the knee kinematic axis. Very important, be aware that AMA and KA technique are two different surgical techniques. Only the flexion of the femoral component follows the same recommendation. Everything else is different. If you're an AMAU surgeon, like most of surgeons, you cannot do a kinematic implantation by chance. This needs to be learned. This is a simple surgical technique, but there is strict rules to follow. So the AMA technique makes everyone the same, while the kinematic alignment technique keeps everyone unique by reproducing knee anatomy and soft tissue balance. So let's talk about the patella. There is a many controversies regarding how and when resurfacing the patella. Some surgeons will always resurface it because they want to prevent the occurrence of anterior knee pain. Some surgeons will never do it because they want to prevent the complication related to the patella resurfacing, like patella fracture, patella component loosening. And some of the surgeons, we do selective resurfacing. For the kinematic technique, it's quite simple. There is so far no evidence to help you in deciding if you should or not resurface the patella. I want you to be well aware that all the evidence that has been generated with the AMA technique do not apply for kinematic knee, and I will explain you later why. So my observation for my personal practice is that anterior knee pain with kinematic knee has almost disappeared. My indication to resurface the patella, it's only for patients with obvious patellofemoral joint disease. You know, those knee where the patella is tilted and shifted laterally, there is a bone on bone lateral arthritis, the patella is remodeled, and often there is some bone loss. So there is a obvious patella matracking. And my guess is that anterior knee pain with mechanical knee is related to lateral retinaculum stretching, lateral facet overload, and quadriceps overuse. And all of this is mainly prevented with a kinematic technique, explaining probably why anterior knee pain has almost disappeared with KA-TKA. So let's look at the MA knee. So when you mechanically align implants, we know that the lateral distal femoral condyle is overstuffed. So you put more implant than you remove bone and cartilage. So when you bend, when the patient bends the knee, so the patella tract around the femoral component, and because of this lateral overstuffing, the lateral retinaculum is stretched. Obviously, if the retinaculum is stretched, there is also high stress on the lateral facet of the patella, and this favors a patella maltracking. Also, when you do a AMA technique with the anterior femoral cut flush to the femoral cortex, we understuff significantly the trochlea. So with your prosthetic trochlea, you understuff the native trochlea. The consequence of this is that the lever arm of the extensor mechanism much reduced. This is between 10 and 25%, which is huge. And obviously, because of this reduction of lever arm, so the quadriceps is overused. The quadriceps need to generate more force strength in order to make the same knee motion. This obviously increases the stress on the patella. Now we know that mechanically aligned knee alter the physiological knee kinematics, and often there is no medial pivot kinematic pattern, or at least insufficient. So we know, like it is illustrated here on the right below images. So when you have a medial pivot kinematic pattern, when you bend the knee, there is a reduction of the Q angle. And this reduction is very good for the biomechanics of the patellofemoral joint, because it even the stress on the patella between medial and lateral facets. If you don't have a medial pivot kinematic pattern, the Q angle does not reduce, and this increases the stress on the lateral facet, as it is shown here. Also, mechanical knee are known to be affected by a paradoxical motion when you bend the knee, mainly for the CR design. When there is a paradoxical motion, the patella tendon angle lower, and this is detrimental for the function of the quadriceps. So there is a quadriceps overuse, which once again increases the stress on the patella. So then, guys, you understand that the patellofemoral joint biomechanics with a mechanical knee is quite poor. And this supports that what I told you before, that the anterior knee pain with MA-TKA is related to lateral retinaculum stretching, lateral facet overload, and quadriceps overuse, or in other words, this is because of the alteration of the knee anatomy and the knee kinematics. And you understand that those complications may be significantly reduced or prevented with a kinematic implantation, because the KA technique try to preserve the individual knee anatomy and knee kinematics. And this would be probably even more true if the kinematic implantation was done with a medial pivot total knee design. Because with the ball in the socket design on the medial side, the paradoxical motion is prevented, and the medial pivot kinematic pattern is favored with this design. The synergistic effect between KA and medial pivot has been shown by a publication from French, and they show that the kinematic knee had a much better perception, as estimated with the forgotten joint score, compared to CR knee, knowing that both knee, medial pivot and TR, were kinematically aligned. Also, we've got local data from my institution. So those data are from ODEP patients, prospective collection of data. And we show that the patient with medial pivot kinematic knee, they had at 1 year an excellent function with a median Oxford score at 44, median satisfaction at 1 year, 99%, extremely high, and no anterior knee pain were present on those 40 consecutive medial pivot kinematic implantation. Other publication deserve to be talked about. So Jean Dosset showed that when kinematically aligned, patient had much less anterior knee pain compared to mechanical technique. Nam showed that KA knee enabled a much better perception of the knee. So the KA total knee felt more natural, three times more than the AMA total knee. And many authors show that the patellofemoral joint biomechanics of KA patient were much better than the one of MA knee and often close to the normal physiological kinematics. So now you understand why my only indication for resurfacing the patella is a patient with obvious patellofemoral joint disease maltracking, because I resurface the patella in order to prevent patella maltracking, but not to prevent an anterior knee pain, because this is seldom happening with the K technique. Those knee with patella maltracking are the type 4 of the P.A.S. classification. This classification has been published in 2017. There is an update soon released. And this classification lists the many knees that present a challenge when performing a kinematic implantation. So what I want you to remember, guys, is that the anterior knee pain is very rare with kinematic knee. The patella resurfacing is mainly for type 4 knees, so knees with a patella maltracking preoperatively. And obviously, more evidence is awaited. It is important that research focus on this topic in order to generate objective, valid data. So much more to come on personal arthroplasty and kinematic alignment, a book that will be in open access, the Personal Arthroplasty Society, a platform to discuss clinical cases, in addition, of course, of the Kinematic Alignment YouTube channel. So, dear colleague, thank you for listening. I really hope you enjoyed, and see you in the next video. Bye.